Hello, San Antonio. Duke Johnitz with the Beacon, and we are excited about the guests that we have in studio today. Mark Lugo with Mark Lugo Ministries. You know, I don't know if you've been watching the numbers, right? I assume you have. Not everybody else in the world is tracking all the COVID cases, rather their hospitalizations or deaths or new cases. And Mark has a testimony. He's been sharing a little bit of Facebook Live, and that's sort of how the Beacon got wind of this and realized that there was a group here in San Antonio that were warring literally in the heavenlies and praying at every hospital in San Antonio. And so we definitely wanted to bring Mark on, let him share what they've been doing, because it literally may have impacted a family member or a friend that you have that's been in the hospital. And so we're honored to have Mark Lugo. Mark, welcome to Beacon TV.
Hey, Duke, it's always good to be with you, and we love the Beacon. So thank you for having us here.
Well, I think everybody's going to be excited, right, when they hear this. You know, maybe start by just helping our audience understand, you know, what happened for you to be able to form this initiative? What took place?
Well, Duke, obviously, COVID-19 is everyone around the world knows about it. And it's been around all of 2020 for the most part. And for the most part, I've been silent about it. I didn't share much post about it or anything. And so, you know, the recent alerts there at the end of early July, end of June, that we got these alerts on our phone, they were a wake-up call to me. And at that point, Duke, I couldn't be silent anymore. I said, it's kind of like that the line that was drawn in the sand, and my statement was, enough is enough. I cannot be silent. I need to, you know, war spiritually on this now. And I went Facebook Live, Duke, and I posted that alert saying, hey, did anybody else get this alert? And then shortly after that, I went Facebook Live, and I started praying and taking authority over COVID in the name of Jesus. And that was my wake-up call there.
Yeah. Well, and it's based on scripture, right? What was the scripture that we talked about earlier, the one you quoted?
Absolutely. Mark 10:7-8, you know, God commands us to heal the sick. You know, as you go and preach, you know, proclaim that the kingdom of heaven is at hand. He said, heal the sick, cleanse the lepers, raise the dead, and cast out demons. Now, those are four major things in that scripture that God is commanding his disciples to do. And that is an action scripture. It's faith and action together. And that's what was the motivation behind this, to heal the sick. Well, I saw a lot of people sick in hospitals. I saw people dying, you know, in the sense of hearing about it, not literally knowing anybody from it. But, you know, it's just like, you know what? We have the answer. So I couldn't be silent anymore. I had to take action, put faith and action together.
Well, and it's easier now because I guess we've been at this 5 months and still running, maybe than it was at the beginning for those of us that are believers, that are part of the body of Christ, to really recognize that what we're finding ourselves in the midst of is warfare. It's in the heavenlies, right? The scripture says that, you know, tear down principalities and powers in the heavenly realm. And between COVID and the racism and the rioting and the division in our country and the election, you know, it's like the enemy is wanting to strike fear into people across our country. And so the way you win a battle, right, if it's a spiritual battle, is doing exactly what you're doing, going on the offensive and praying prayers of faith and believing that God's going to provide the very thing that he promised in scripture. So I think it's amazing how you started. So how did you recruit? How did that process work?
So God wanted us to take, he's commanded us many times to take authority. And, you know, you mentioned a great point. You know, the spiritual battle is, I know better than to go to battle by myself, brother. So I recruited a team. And, there was four ladies that came to mind, and I called them. I said, would you join me in this initiative to start praying for those that are dealing with COVID, the families that are being affected by COVID? And they were ready. They were ready, you know. And so they said yes. That four turned into 7, turned into 12. And we launched Adopt a Hospital for Prayer. And we have over 250 people in that group that are continuously bombarding heaven for every single patient that's in the hospital and dealing with COVID, even cases. Duke, let me share with you, staff. You know, early July when we started, there was over 1,250 people that were dealing with COVID. This is an actual stat that the city of San Antonio gives. There was actually to quote it exactly on July 13th, there was 1,267 cases of COVID. Okay. A month later from the prayer initiative, it went down nearly 50%. That was our gauge to see how are we doing in the prayers. You know, you can pray, you know, you can pray that that's awesome. And it is effective. But when you can see the results from a third party, you know, testifying of what God is doing, that is amazing. You know, working together with them.
You know, without people knowing that this initiative is going on, they would have given all of the credit, right, to not gathering and more than 10 to a group and mask. And I'm not saying that those things don't help, right? Obviously, we're in a position where we need to be able to obey the local government in terms of mask wearing.
Yeah.
But looking at how far the numbers have dropped, you know, I keep up with it on the news. And the last 3 or 4 days, there hasn't been more than 120 to 180 new cases, down from, you know, mid 1200s and when you guys started the initiative. So how many hospitals have you actually prayed at?
Duke, that's a great question. We've prayed at all the hospitals in San Antonio.
Wow.
And, you know, in surrounding area, I just knew that we had to touch the ground. We had to, you know, we were the hands and feet of Jesus, and he said to go, right? And you know, so we would declare and decree heaven on earth and begin to take back the ground that belonged to God. And you know, the word of God says, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. So we were declaring heaven on earth. And in God's heaven, it's in God's kingdom, there's no sickness, brother.
I know
in God's
where you
kingdom,
were going.
There's no lack. What's that?
I said, I know where you were going with that.
Everything that we need, every single promise is in the kingdom of God. So sickness is trespassing. Yeah. COVID is trespassing. So we begin to declare and decree that San Antonio is COVID-free. Texas is COVID-free. The United States is COVID-free. You know, and so we declared and decreed these promises over and over. We didn't use so much our words, dude. We used the word of God to go send it forth, declare it and decree it. And the Bible says his word will not return void.
Yeah.
And let me tell you how it didn't return void. We got testimony after testimony of God answering prayers. Ruby de los Santos was in the hospital. Her family called. They said, hey, Ruby's in the hospital. She's having a hard time breathing. And okay, we went to work and we started praying. I said, keep us posted. Because this is one of the things, Duke, is we didn't want families to reach out to us and just say, hey, I need prayer for this person and just leave it there.
Right.
We were literally journeying with every single family that came through. Every name was every person was a name. They weren't a number, and we would pray for that name specifically, and we would get the symptoms, and we would pray, God, heal the symptoms of pneumonia, Father, heal the symptoms of shortness of breath, and Father, we cast away that ventilator. You know, Ruby was so close, Duke, of getting on the ventilator. Her oxygen levels were in the 70s, but let me tell you. Initially, there were small steps of progress, but then all of a sudden, boom, we saw rapid improvement. And Ruby, within 4 weeks, was able to go home and be with her family.
I love it, she's
alive and well today.
God, right?
Because the power of prayer was the answer.
Well, and I don't think it's really stopped there. Right? I mean, haven't you been getting phone calls and hey, what are you guys doing in San Antonio? And, you know, maybe we can do the same thing in our city. Talk to me a little bit about that.
Yeah. So the amazing thing is, the power of just a word of mouth. And so we are now in 5 states, you know, people who are adopting hospitals in 5 states, brother, from South Carolina to Tennessee to Florida, all, you know, of course, Texas here, and just several states, Maryland, you know, all these states have joined in, and there are people that are adopting their hospitals. They're going and they're walking the grounds. Some people even, Duke, they even drive around the hospital. But there's something about going and seeing the land. It's like those two spies, right?
Yeah.
So we are facing the giant here of COVID-19. And as a matter of fact, just like Goliath, he didn't see a man of size. He saw a man that would go down in the name of Jesus. It wasn't size to him. It was this man was illegally trespassing and coming against his God. And so COVID was coming in illegally. And so, you know, God is greater than COVID. You know, I started saying that over and over. God is greater than COVID-19. It's weak. It's just a name that has to bow down to the name of Jesus. So we just need to take that authority in that arena of healing and declare and decree it over people. Now, here's another thing, Duke. I want to say this. You know, Second Chronicles, I've seen that Second Chronicles, chapter two, where in Second Chronicles, if my people will call on my name.
Oh, chapter seven, yeah, verse 14.
Yes, chapter seven, verse, yes, thank you. And, you know, about healing the land and asking for forgiveness. You know, I think what we're dealing with here, this is my opinion, Duke, is that we're dealing with more with the Genesis 1:28 issue, which is for God says to subdue, replenish, fill, multiply, be fruitful, and have dominion. I believe that God has deployed his church through COVID-19. You know, churches are empty most parts, right? You know, we've experienced that. The church has been deployed. God wants us to get outside the four walls and into the communities and into business, into arts and entertainment, into government, into every sphere of influence of society and bring the gospel to those atmospheres, bring and have dominion in those platforms for his kingdom's sake, to usher in kingdom on earth.
Love heaven it. On right. earth. It's really simple, right? It's just praying God's word and taking authority based on what he says in scripture, not on anything that we might be able to do. You know, and we're certainly not wanting to hurt the feelings of doctors and nurses and those people that are really on the front lines that are dealing with it from a medical standpoint. You know, they're able to save lives too, but you throw prayer in the mix, bro, and man, their batting average probably goes through the roof, right? So how can somebody get involved, Mark? If somebody wanted to support what's going on financially, or they wanted to become part of a prayer group, or maybe somebody in another state is hearing this, and wants to learn more, where would they go? How do they get hold of it?
Well, Duke, yeah, I'll answer that question. I know we're running out of time here, but let me just share this with you too before we go, is that there's a pastor. He shared with me, that he recently went into the hospital, and he was having shortness of breath, okay? And he went into the hospital about a week ago. This is about five weeks later after we've from that huge stat that I shared with you, right? You know, over 1,200 people, cases. And he said, man, you know, you came, well, you're here. The paramedic told him, he said, if you were here over a month ago, man, the university hospital was packed. But all of a sudden, you know, just out of nowhere, the numbers started to drop dramatically. The words of a paramedic, dude, that was testifying to what God was doing.
I love it.
It's amazing. Now, you know, just if you want to get connected with us, you can go. I mean, we encourage everybody to go to Adopt the Hospital for Prayer. It's a Facebook group. So that's would be the only way to join it. Or you can reach us through Mark Lugo Ministries. Now, we have a website for that, marklugoministries.org, You can connect with us through there. And, you know, send us a message, you know, obviously too, through the Facebook group. You know, when you send us your prayer request, it gets shared with over 250 minimum intercessors. On top of that, they get shared with other groups. And so you're literally looking at thousands of people bombarding heaven. and I love it when God does that.
When God does that work that's organic, right? So no marketing, you know, nobody sent invitations out, formal invitations, but God got the word out and people responded. Let me close maybe, Mark, just for praying for you and your group. Would that be all right?
Yeah, absolutely. Thank you.
Father, we want to acknowledge your name again in this conversation and give you all the glory for what's taking place in San Antonio and other states and cities across the nation. As people step up as your ambassadors, boldly declaring and decreeing your word, we are humbled this evening, Father, that for some unknown reason, we're plan A and there's no plan B. And you've granted us, you say in your word, everything we need in the kingdom. So we do say, thy kingdom come, Lord, and thy will be done. And we know that that includes defeating all that's going on in our country right now, the pandemic, the COVID-19 disease, the racial tension, the division as we come towards the election. Lord, we call and pull on your kingdom now to come to San Antonio and our country. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
Mark, thank you, brother. We'll stay in touch. We'll get an update when it's all the way down to case zero, right? We'll come back and get another update.
Yes, that'd be awesome. Thank you.
God bless you, man. Thanks for coming.
God bless you. Thanks for having me. Love y'all.